everyone. It's Alexandra from Novato Gymnastics. Thanks so much for joining me today. Today we're going to be focusing on our turning skills, so pivot turns, heel snap turns, and half turns on balance beam. So all you're really going to need is a firm surface, so a hardwood floor works or carpet, and then some sort of line. So if you don't have a floor beam at home, you can use a painter's tape to create a balance beam on your floor. You can also just imagine that you have a straight line in front of you to work on. When you're ready, let's get started. Okay, let's start doing 20 jumping jacks. Here we go, ready. In, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Very good. Okay, go to your line, your floor balance beam, and we're gonna just jump from one side to the other side to warm up our legs and our ankles a little bit. So we're gonna go up and over. Nice job. Let's do four more, ready? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Great job. All right, let's stand with our legs a little bit apart in a straddle. Arms out to the side, hand on it, and stretch over to one side. Very good, you should feel a stretch in your side body right here. And switch. Look up underneath your armpit towards the ceiling. Good, arms out to the side with a flat back. Hinge forward, hold right about here. Good, and then fold all the way down. We call this our sandwich position. Hands are nice and flat. Let's go up onto releve, and then backwards onto our heels. Good, let's try that 5 times. All the way up, and back. That's 1, releve, heels. 2, 3, nice and slow. 4, good, and 5. Very nice. From here, walk your hands over to your right foot, and we're going to create a triangle, a standing triangle. If this is a little bit too challenging for you, go ahead and bend that front leg just a little bit. That way you can reach your hands to the floor. But if you can, get those legs straight. Go ahead and do that. Good, and then from here, we're going to actually scooch our back foot back, bend our front leg. So we're in a runner's lunge. In this stretch, your back leg is straight, but your front leg is bent. Hands are on either side of your front foot. Very good. Let's hold this for 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very good. Keep this leg straight. Stay up on the ball of your foot. Bring those arms up. Good yoga. This is called your crescent lunge. But you should really feel your back leg and your front leg activating. Very good. Go back down. Scoot your legs into your triangle. Rotate back to your sandwich. And let's try that same thing on the opposite side. So triangle to start. You're trying to get your legs straight. It's okay though if you need a slight bend in your front foot, in your front leg, excuse me. Good, and then from here, runner's lunge. Front leg is bent, back leg is straight and nice and tight. Hands are on either side of your front foot. Let's hold this for 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come all the way up, crescent lunge. So your back leg is tight, you're on the ball of your foot, front leg is bent, and nice and engaged. Stretch tall towards the ceiling. Very good, reverse back to triangle. Sandwich, hands flat in the middle. Let's do 5 more sandwich rocks. So you're gonna go up onto releve, backwards onto your heels. We're really warming up our ankles and our calves today for all of our turning work. onto your heels. This is easy for some people. This is a pretty easy position for me to hang out in. For others, this is really challenging. It all depends on your mobility in your ankles, your calves. Good, and also your Achilles. If this is a little bit challenging, it's okay to be up on your toes like this. Just try to hold it. Very good, hands down. And up into a standing pike. Good, and we're gonna pedal our legs so you can bend one knee and then switch. Very good. And slowly stand up. All right, we are ready to get started. So walk over to your floor beam or to the line that you've created for yourself or your imaginary line, that works too. And we're gonna start with our right foot in front. Right foot in front. When we're on balance beam, we basically have our feet pointed one in front of the other. We're like this, if you can see my feet. We always wanna have all 10 toes on top of the beam. So our feet are not gonna be turned out in a ballet position. We're gonna actually have our feet relatively parallel. So hips are pointing forward, feet are forward, all 10 toes on top of the beam or on top of your line. All right, let's start with one foot in front. Legs are straight. All 10 toes are on your balance beam or on your line. Very good, knees are tight, buns are tight, abs are engaged, shoulders are down, and you have a nice long neck. You're trying to be as tall as possible from your belly button to the top of your head. Hands are on our hips. Good, let's start by holding releve. Maintain that really nice straight line for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower down. Very nice. Now we're gonna go up onto releve and back down onto our heels 10 times. Maintain a really tight core, tight booty, and keep those legs really tight. So your inner thighs, pretend there's a zipper between your knees all the way up, and that's gonna stay glued together. All right, here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Let's hold again for 10, 9, 8. We'll really tighten our legs. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower down and shake it out. You should really feel your calves and your hamstrings engaging on those. Good. And then we're going to switch and do the other side. So opposite foot in front. Hips are square. Feet are pointing forward. All 10 toes are on your balance beam or on your floor line. Start by squeezing the legs, squeezing the buns. Abs in, shoulders down, long neck, hands on hips. Hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower down. Heel raises, ready, lift, 1, down, 2, down, 3, down, 4, down, 5, down, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last hold. Tight legs, squeeze the booty, abs are tight, shoulders are down, neck is long, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very good, shake it out. All right, the first turn we're gonna practice is called a pivot turn. So in a pivot turn, you're gonna do a half circle and you're gonna be turning one way and then turning the other way. The trick is to know which way to turn. So when you're in releve with one foot in front, I want you to look down towards your big toe. Wherever your big toe is, that's the direction that you're gonna turn. So on our beam, start in beam feet. So feet are forward, hips are square. You're gonna go up onto releve. Look down for your big toe. That's gonna tell you which way to turn. And then staying up, you're gonna twist and stop, doing a half turn. Very good, let's try that again. So look down at your toes, find your big toe, and turn in that direction. Very nice, so it's a little tricky. The goal is to stay up on releve for the whole half turn. with your legs glued together. So let's try that a few more times. Shake out your knees, shake out your feet. Hands are on hips to start. Legs are tight, booty's tight, abs are in. Releve. Pivot. Very good. Hold. And then we're gonna go the opposite way. Pivot. That was a little bit harder for me. Very good. If it's easy for you to do that on your hips, we're gonna next try that with our arms in crown. So you're trying to create a soft arc with your arms. Middle fingers are just about touching, like that. All right, let's give it a try. So let's start with our arms in crown, buns are under, releve, pivot, good, hold, and pivot. And then you can melt your arms down. Very good, shake it up. So that's called our pivot turn. Next, we're gonna work on a coupe and a passe position for a heel snap turn. This is a little bit more advanced, but it's great to practice. And I'm gonna actually start facing you so you can see me a little bit easier. Hands on hips. We're gonna bring one foot, point that foot, right next to your ankle bone. This is called coupe. Very good. Now slide that toe up to your knee. This is called passe. So we're gonna work on both positions, turning in a passe and turning in coupe. Good, let's try the other side. We're gonna balance in coupe, bring the toe up to passe. We're almost creating a table here. Back down to coupe. Very good, shake it out. Now let's try that on your floor beam or on your line. We're gonna actually bring our arms up to beach ball. So create that arc, middle fingers are just about touching, and then lift it up. I call this beach ball. So we're gonna hold our arms here, and we're gonna start by holding coupe, sliding our foot up to passe, hold, back down to coupe. Good, two more times, passe, hold, coupe, hold. Last round, passe, coupe. Very good, now we're gonna step forward into a demi-plie, plie, crown, press finish. Very good. All right, let's try that on the other side. So now you're gonna bring your other foot up to to coupe. Arms are in beach ball. Passe. Coupe. Passe. Last round. Coupe. Passe. Step forward into a demi-plie. Plie, crown, press finish. Very good. Okay, now we're gonna add the heel lift. So we're gonna lift our heel up in those positions. This is a little bit harder, so it's okay if you wobble. It takes a little bit of practice. Okay, let's start in a coupe. So our foot is down by our ankle. Good, we're just gonna simply lift our heel and then lower down. Very good, now we'll go up to passe, try the same thing. Lift your heel, lower down. Good, two more. Coupe, lower down. Passe, lower down. Last round. Coupe. Passe. Good, step forward. Plie, crown, press finish. Nice job. All right, other side. This side's a little bit harder for me, so bear with me. One side's definitely gonna be easier than the other, that's okay. But we always wanna practice both sides so that we're developing even muscles. All right, coupe, heel goes up and down, good. Passe, up, down. Coupe, up, down. Passe, up, down. Coupe, oops, wobbling a little bit, passe. Up, down, very good. Plie, crown, press, finish. Awesome work, shake it out. All right, now let's just focus on our passe position. For the most part, in gymnastics on balance beam, you're gonna be turning up in passe, but it's good to practice both positions. Let's start on the floor. Hands on our hips. In passe with our knee pointing forward. Good. Now, maintaining alignment, we're gonna go out and then back in. Very good, again, out, and back in. It's tricky when you bring your knee out because your more weight is out here to the side. So it's a little bit harder to balance. And then back in. Let's try that with our arms in beach ball. Out, hold your line. Back in. Good. One more. Out. Back in. Very good. Shake it out. All right, onto the other side. Passe. Hold your nice straight line. Amazing posture. Out. And in. Very good. This side's a little bit harder for me. Out. Back in. Good. Out. Back in. Cool. Beach ball. Out. It might help to pick a spot on the floor in front of you to really stare at that spot. It'll help you balance. Very good. Shake it out. Get all your wiggles out. All right. Now let's try a heel snap turn. So in a heel snap turn, you have to maintain your straight line from your heel all the way up to the crown of your head, your knee in passe, and you're gonna focus on lifting your heel up and down. So you're doing those three things, holding your alignment, holding your passe position, and lifting your heel up and down. So we're gonna start with our arms and beach ball, one leg up in passe, and we're gonna see if we can twist around. Good. And then try the other side. One side's gonna be harder than the other. That's totally normal. Good. Hold your alignment. Hold your passe position. And then your heel is gonna go up, down. Good. And for a heel snap turn, you're gonna be turning towards your baby toe. So we're gonna go the opposite direction as we did on our pivot turns. So on a pivot turn, I asked you to look for your big toe. For a heel snap turn, I want you to look for your baby toe. So you're gonna turn towards your baby toe this time. Let's try that again. Passe. Heel snap turn. Very good. Let's try that again. Passe. Heel snap turn. Very good. This just takes lots of practice. A great way to practice is if you have hardwood or tile floors, you can put on socks and it's a little easier to spin on your toes. Okay, the last turn we're gonna practice today is a half turn. So this time, we're gonna actually start with our arms in a crown and we're gonna step onto a straight leg like so. This is called a pique turn. So we're gonna step onto releve and bring our back leg up to passe, like that. And we're gonna see if we can turn. Very good. These are just for a beginning turn. Hold those ribs in, straight line, and turn. Very good. If you know how to start with your arms here and then go up, you can go ahead and try that. If you've not learned that in class, just focus on maintaining your arms and crown and working on your alignment. And then it'll be easy when we teach the arms. Very good. And it's okay. One side's a little bit easier, a little bit harder. All right. I hope you enjoy practicing your turns at home. Keep working on them, and I promise you'll get a lot better. And when we get back into the gym, you'll be able to do them up here. All right, thank you.